हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू योर ओन चैनल फिनस्टॉप, द वन स्टॉप डेस्टिनेशन फॉर स्टॉक मार्केट एंड फाइनेंशियल प्लानिंग। गाइस, आई एम हियर टू ब्रिंग यू एन गोल्डन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू बाय दिस एविएशन स्टॉक। दिस स्टॉक हैज फॉलन फ्रॉम द लेवल्स ऑफ 153 टू 30 एंड इट इज प्रेजेंटली ट्रेडिंग एट द लेवल ऑफ 70। द स्टॉक हैज फॉलन बाय 52%, एरोडिंग मोर देन 50% ऑफ द इन्वेस्टर्स अमाउंट। The stock was badly impacted due to the COVID first wave and second wave, and it is undergoing huge financial stress. And the stock is none other than SpiceJet. Guys, it is an excellent opportunity for you guys, as stock is available at 52% discounted price. As demand for domestic travel picking up day by day, we can expect at least 30% jump in the stock price in coming days. SpiceJet is an Indian low-cost airlines, headquartered in Gurgaon, Haryana. It is the second largest airlines in the country by the number of domestic passengers carried till March 2019. Now it has fallen to 4th position. There is an important breaking news about SpiceJet, guys. On November 1st, some employees of SpiceJet engineering department went on strike at Delhi airport protesting reduced salary and improper disbursement. They demanded for increase in their salaries to pre-COVID level. They gathered outside the Terminal 3 of New Delhi's Indira Gandhi International Airport holding banners saying pay our deferred salaries and no pay, no work. Soon the protest has spread to 8 other key airports in the country including Mumbai, Bengaluru, Kolkata and Hyderabad. The employees complained that they are still being paid below the COVID levels. That is, almost 60% of their salaries are only being paid and they are not even giving their weekly offs. After their strike from November 1st to November 5th for pre-COVID salaries, SpiceJet management finally agrees to address some employees to pay their demands. And from November 5th, the work was restored for daily operations. Guys, whenever this kind of strikes occurs in any company, it will hugely impact the investor's sentiment. So guys, in this video, let us analyze this stock technically, and in the end I am going to give you levels and targets for taking a swing trade. Before going further, I would request you to watch my playlist of multi-bagger stocks, stock market for beginners and mutual funds. Also please follow us on Telegram channel, you can find important updates on daily basis. Also please follow us on Instagram and Facebook, the links are in the description box. Please don't forget to hit the like button and please subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit the bell icon for all important notifications. Now let's come back to the topic. If you see its 1 week chart, the stock has fallen by 2.52%. If you see its 1 month chart, the stock has given negative returns of minus 4.72%. But if you see 1 year chart, the stock has managed to give good returns of 40.82%. Guys, before analyzing the stock technically, let us quickly touch upon its fundamentals. Firstly, let us see its business. SpiceJet main revenue is generated from domestic air travel, and it also generates revenue from its Spice Club membership. In order to attract its customers, it has launched Spice Club with several features, like it provides flight vouchers, it gives Spice Club points, it also provides free charge or cancellation option, and it provides complimentary upgrades, complimentary meals, priority check-in services, free seat selection, and exclusive deals and offers. And in order to provide entertainment for its customers in the air, SpiceJet has come up with exclusive feature Spice Screen, where you can find several movies, music, etc. SpiceJet's most profitable business is through its multimodal logistics platform, Spice Express, which enables movement of cargo from anywhere in the world to anywhere in the world in the most efficient and cost-effective manner. It has got good client base of L&T, DHL, Sony, Amazon, Flipkart and several other clients. Now let's see its financials. The company's revenue has increased from 7.89 to 13.21 from 2018 to 2020, and it has fallen from 13.21 to 6 in 2021. If you see its profits, company has turned from profits of 0.56 thousand crores to -1.03 thousand crores in 2021. So guys, why losses? The main reason is COVID pandemic. When DGCA declared the market numbers for September, SpiceJet was relegated to the fourth spot, a significant drop for an airline that was the undisputed number 2 until last year. Things changed for the industry in May 2021 as the second wave of pandemic moved towards a peak. We saw the number of passengers carried plummeting in May. SpiceJet ferried only less than 2 lakh passengers, leading to a single digit market share. This COVID pandemic has driven SpiceJet into huge financial stress, which forced it to reduce its presence in the passenger segment. As it is undergoing huge financial stress, it is unable to pay its employees full salary, and this is causing huge employee attrition. Employee attrition means employees are willing to leave the company and wishes to join the other competitors. Guys, now the COVID pandemic is subdued and the demand for domestic air travel has been increasing rapidly. So guys, to recover from its losses, what should be the future outlook of SpiceJet? SpiceJet is planning to raise a capital of 2500 crores through QIP, qualified institutional placement, by selling its cargo business on slump sale basis. And it can improve sustained revenues from Udaan routes, where it enjoys exclusive monopoly. And by adding additional flights to Dubai, it will help the airline balance revenue streams and increase its profitability. Now let us analyze this stock technically by using charts. Friends, I am using Zerodha for chart analysis. If you want to open a DMAT account through Zerodha, the link is in the description box. Here I have opened SpiceJet 1-day chart. The stock has fallen from the levels of 150 and it is presently trading at 70.55. The RSI is almost flat and it is presently near 40. If you see its MACD indicator, it is still bearish. If you see its volumes, the volumes are very low from almost 2 months. Also guys, there is a demand zone between the levels of 60 to 66 where the stock has bounced back almost 4 times. So we can expect the stock to enter into this demand zone from the levels of 70.55 to 60 or 66 like this, and it can touch the levels up to 60 and it can start a fresh rally. It can rise towards 70, 75, it can even cross 80 plus levels. Now let's see some buy levels and targets. The buy levels are level 1 65, level 2 63, level 3 60. The targets are target 1 73, target 2 76, target 3 82. You can keep the stop loss at 58 and the time period you have to hold is 2 to 12 weeks for achieving these targets. Friends, please invest your amount partially at each and every buy level and also at each and every dip and between the demand zone of 60 to 66 only, so that you can get at least 30% returns in coming 12 weeks. Guys, if you are an aviation lover, it is a wonderful opportunity for you guys. The demand for domestic air travel is increasing day by day and SpiceJet is planning to raise the capital to recover from its losses. It is an excellent opportunity for you guys to pick this stock near the demand zone between the levels of 60 to 66 for both long term and for swing trade. If you have any doubts, please write in the commentary box. This is all about SpiceJet guys. I will come up with another interesting swing trade stock in coming days. A small disclaimer for you guys, the levels, targets and recommendations are only for educational purpose. Please do your own research and consult your financial advisor before taking investment decision. If you like my explanation, please like, share, comment and please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you friends.